42 on Sirius XM.
It's just different, fam.
So today's 420, right? Yeah, 420, exactly. No, I don't think I have a joint roll, so I'll just smoke some vape. But, you know, what really gets me is that now there's all these commercials for dispensaries and sort of on Sirius, and people are selling, you know, different things that you know, like that have the flavor of the brand, the weed strain. You know. And more, you know, all these tobacco companies are all lined up to, you know, start selling them as well in packages and, you know, make money off. So that's the difference between decriminalization and legalization. Legalization means that it's legal to sell it and buy it, but it has to be taxed and it has to be monitored. The other one, decriminalizing it allows it to, like, if you want to, like, it's like a tomato plant. You want to grow it as a tomato plant, grow it. Whatever you want to do, you want to give it away to friends, whatever. We're not paying attention. It should never have been criminalized. It should have never been legal anyway. And you see which one they pick. They always pick legalized, not decriminalized. That's the number one thing. Also, do you understand that people spent time in jails and cages? I spent 28 days in a cage because I had a half a joint in my pocket in Asbury 10 years ago. I swear to God, I had 28 days in jail. I spent, because my sister, I didn't have the money to bail myself out. They picked me up, they arrested me. I had a warrant for a ticket that I didn't pay for in Newark. And they brought me in, and the judge says, oh, she has one, it's $7,500 bill, and that was $750. And my sister refused to put it up because she didn't believe it was just marijuana. She thought it was something else. So she left me in jail for 28 days while she went and talked to a lawyer, and the lawyer, you know, talked to the judge, you know, and everything. And the lawyer came back, yeah, it was just a joint. And so, and she finally bailed me out. And I paid her back. But. So if you don't have anybody out, if you ever get arrested, if you don't have anybody on the outside that you can really trust and help you, you're fucked. The warning for that. So, you know, I spent 20 days, but people have spent years and years in jail for sale, distribution, or whatever. It's a plant. It's a plant. It's a gift from God. It should be given away for freely. It should be allowed to be grown, and it should grow wild everywhere. You can just pick the buds. You know? It's a gift from God. And if you don't know why it's a gift from God, it's just, and who called it a gift from God originally, it's Jamaican culture. But that's in another video. Find that. I'm gonna tell the story again, but all those people that spent time in a cage, right? It was unnecessarily. Same thing with the people that were I mean, you know, most of them were criminals though. They were criminals in one way, so they that's what the mentality is, but it's not true. Some people were just growing it in their house. People were just, you know, supplying it to, because they were making, you know, they were selling it so they could at least they didn't have to pay for their own stuff, you know. It was paying for their own use of it, which is expensive. $400 an ounce. I can go through 2 ounces in a month. It's $800 a month. And I have a medical marijuana card. And I can get 2 ounces, I can get 3 ounces a month. I can't afford it. And I'm a dispensary, especially now. But none of those people that spent time in a cage for the mistake that they made by making it illegal. That was a mistake. They have to accept that that's a mistake that they made, making it illegal. And those people that spent time in cages should not have spent time in cages. And they should be, ask for forgiveness and given some compensation for their life that was lost. If nobody out there has ever been to jail and sat in a cage listening to this, I guarantee you, it's a fucked up, one of the worst feelings, next to maybe like, I don't know, waiting to die or getting a gun pointed at your head. I mean, you know what I mean? It's one of the worst feelings ever. Your freedom is taken away to the point where it's just like, you know. So we finally, the people that the family passed the laws in this state, and they're slowly going through all their state, but some states are still considered illegal. The people making those laws and keeping those laws going, don't you think they're paid by the pharmaceutical companies? Don't you think there's a reason why they're, I don't want my kids smoking marijuana? I guarantee you, man. Especially if it's illegal, your kids are gonna smoke it. You know why? Because it's the thing you do. Okay? Kids are not supposed to be drinking before the age of 18, some places 21, and they do. Kids are not supposed to be driving before the age of 16 and they got a problem, and they do. So making it illegal is not gonna stop your kids from using it. It's gonna be the opposite. But what it's gonna do is unnecessarily put people in cages for no reason other than these people that are still keeping it illegal. The kickbacks they're getting from the pharmaceutical companies that are worried that this is gonna take, plant medicine is gonna take the place of all the investment they made in these pharmaceuticals. They have all these side effects. And I'm assuming it's killing me. I'm assuming it had a lot to do with the COVID deaths. So all these people, because a group of people decided to make a law that made a plant illegal. And everyone that's still now in the same thing, I know, but I think when I was in jail for 28 days in Monmouth County, I met a black gentleman, that had a bag of dope in his pocket, and he ended up, because he was on probation or something like that, parole or something, he had to serve a year because of it. Well, in Portugal, everything is legal now, everything is decriminalized now, and you know, if you really need a bag because your body's like, you know, has to, you know, it's craving it, and you're gonna go through withdrawals, they'll give you a bag. You don't have to do things that you don't want to do, especially do something illegal that'll get you in jail. I mean, this is the thing, man. You look at other places and you consider this country so like, you know, the most advanced country in the world. I mean, I don't know, America, I don't believe that, but whatever. And I guarantee you the Mayans and the Incan and the Aztec, they were much more advanced than any of you. But you think that how do the people that are still keeping these laws in place, and that goes for every other thing. Like I said, look at Portugal and make that an example of what decriminalizing all drugs would do. It would literally free up a lot of the police officers' time. Maybe the DEA agents are not going to have all that funding anymore because, you know, of everything they confiscate. But the amount of lives that are persecuted for these things that one group of people deem is illegal is disheartening, man. All these people that are still in a cage for selling plants that were used for thousands of years medicinally, And maybe they started making some money with it and started doing something with it. They make it, they made it more attractive. But that's because it's illegal, number one, and number two, and there's money to be made with it. If it wasn't illegal and there was no money to be made to it, they wouldn't be doing that. So you put the society puts the crimes out there, right? For people to do. They put the crimes out there for people to do. And then they watch as your own citizens commit the crimes, and then you send your security guards over there to stick them in cages. That's your system of law. And the people that are creating these laws, they're creating these laws of deeming what is legal and what is not, what is now, you know, deemed, you know, a controlled substance. Who are they? Do they drink? Can I go in and make alcohol illegal so I can get them arrested? How about food? Do they eat? Can I make food illegal so I can get them arrested and thrown into cages like they threw me in a cage and they threw everybody else in a cage? Can I do that? Why? Why can I do that as a human? As a member of your civilization? Why? Who gave him the power? You voted for him to take your children and stick them in cages? Really? You see? Those are the things that are stopping your civilization from advancing, because you have what I just said is the cure for all that. Okay? Unnecessarily putting humans in cages and making them spend the rest of their lives, you know, crossing borders with stuff and then making that such a bad crime that they spend, you know, years in jail for it. Those are the things that I deem illogical. And really fuck up to allow these laws to continue. Because whoever made those laws is an arrogant, stupid fucking asshole that doesn't understand about tribal cultures, doesn't understand about plant medicine, doesn't understand about the things that people are forced to do because they've been ripped away from their tribal past. And then they feel, you know, isolated and alone and depressed and you want to feed them pharmaceuticals, but they would prefer plant medicine. And unfortunately, the plant medicine that they can get is only the stuff that the criminal element can produce. In most cases, sometimes no, and it's good if you know somebody. But you know, all in all, it's the criminal element that's producing. So there's a crime involved, and then there's gangs. And the gangs are fighting over who has the turf to sell. These are the things that these things being illegal have created and will continue to create. So when do you think that these lawmakers, the people that actually wrote these laws and are able to wipe them away like the marijuana, when do you think that these people will finally get to the point where they can then deem everything decriminalized, like Portugal? I'm saying Portugal is a lot more advanced of a civilization than you guys are. Knowing that they did that, they've advanced themselves to the point where, yeah, they understand that these are human beings and we have to treat them with respect. And if they need to do this, then we'll allow them to do it. There's no reason that you should not allow them to do it. They're going to OD. The only reason they OD is because they vary on the stuff that they usually get, and one day they get not so good stuff, and then they do two bags, three bags, and then the next day they do the same thing, but it's really good stuff. They didn't know that, and all of a sudden, you know, three bags are going to kill them. It's because you have made it illegal, and made it so that they have to do anything they can to go to the street and get it. So it's not their fault. I don't even think it's a drug dealer's fault. It's your fault for allowing this thing to be illegal. It's like if I make, I don't know, Pepsi Cola illegal. And then if people still want Pepsi Cola, like, yo, I got some Pepsi here, you go in. But you really give me like a, you know, a Fanta Cola or something. Like, what? It's not Pepsi? He's like, well, I want a Pepsi, man. Like, you know? Stupid. And then you get caught with the Pepsi Cola can. It's like, oh, you spend, you know, in jail, and then they go for a judge, you have to pay fines. Like, really? You see how much of a waste of time that is? If we didn't have money, we didn't have to. The law, the whole law system would be pretty much wiped away. Right? We wouldn't have judges. Judges, all they do is decide between, you know. It's basically they protect the rich and the poor. The whole legal system protects the rich and the poor. That's it. And the you know, security, which you call the police. That's what they do. And they do it well because, you know, it's all about money. So if you don't have money when you go into that court, the lawyer, you're gonna lose. So, this is the thing. You have to decide as a civilization if you're going to allow these people that continue doing these things, creating these laws, and putting them, keeping them in place. You know, they're fighting over the fucking, they're fighting over anything, you know. They're fighting over, like, you know, funding for to fix the freaking roadways, man. Whatever that shit's called, stimulus plan, whatever that shit's called. For years, months and years, they've been fighting over shit, right? And they can't get down to the fact that there's human beings that are in cages right now that probably shouldn't be in cages. Because the things you deemed illegal years ago probably shouldn't be deemed legal now. They shouldn't have been deemed legal years ago, but now, especially now, you know, as you have the nerve to make marijuana illegal, legal, and then you forget about the other ones. You know, the coca leaf is going like, and the poppy is going, what about us, man? We're still in here. And like, and the marijuana leaf, yeah, man, they're going to make money on me, so I don't care. They can't make money on you, but they can make money on me. That's why they made me illegal, okay? They can make money off the marijuana. They can't make money off the heroin and the fucking, and the cocaine. You know? They can't make money off of it because, I guess they can't push it, you know, because if you do too much of it, you know. And you know, why do you need heroin when you can have Oxycontin? But you can't have, because you can't get addicted to Oxycontin, so you only get, you know. That's the reason they're on the Oxycontin is because they were on dope. Oh, actually, because they hurt the leg, right? And then when you cut away their ability to get the Oxycontin anymore, guess where they go? I can't get a script for where I go, in the street, to get another Oxycontin? No, that means they get another bag of dope in, man. That'll take away the pain. Right. Who created that, them? You're blaming the addict, you're blaming the dealer, blame the society, blame your fucking leaders, man. That are too busy fucking fighting over, squabbling over some money, over a stimulus plan, instead of looking at the people that are right now sitting in cages unnecessarily. See, if they were sitting, and their children, they were, like Bill Clinton, right? You know, his brother, like I said in the last one, his brother, I did a line of coke with him. I fucking smoked weed with him. He was dealing, you know, because he was a freaking, he was, my friend's brother was bringing him cocaine to distribute throughout Arkansas. I know that for a fact. That's why he got arrested. He didn't serve any time, because he's got the money. And he's got, you know, his brother that was the governor of Arkansas, and he wanted to make sure that he can make it to president without any problems. So they kind of shoved it down. And then later on, he admits to having a drug problem, and he's all right now. He's like, yeah, but how about my friend that spent 2 years in a cage for you? Because, you know. That's what I mean, man. Hypocrisy. Now, if the brother was in jail, oh, let's try to get him out, you know. But anybody else, doesn't matter, right? Because they committed the crimes that you deem as being crimes and make illegal the things that they and their culture, maybe, or human beings in general, need and crave. The coca plant was used as a communication device to other dimensions, long before it was deemed illegal by the tribal culture. And then it was used as a party thing. Hey, you know, stay up a couple of days and drink all you want. Okay, tell them they can't do more than a certain amount. And test them, train, teach them. You know, but this problem here is like, everybody uses these things for partying and woohoo, going out and drinking on the weekend. Yeah. But originally they were used as for rituals and spiritually to connect. You slaughtered all those natives. You took away their tribal customs. You stuck them in front of a TV and a factory in front of TV. And then when they get the craving to do that tribal thing they used to do, you say, no, you can't do that. If you do it, we'll throw you in your cage. That's what you've done to me. And to me. And to everyone like me. And like them. That have to suffer through these archaic laws. These laws that make no sense. If you boil down to the fact that if there was no money, none of that. It's the same thing. It's like if you remove wealth, then poverty goes away and we're all middle class. If you remove money, then all the things that happen because of money go away. And these people that are in cages could be let out tomorrow. With no reason that they would commit the crime again, because it wouldn't be a crime anymore. So think about it. Is that, again, what you want to hand down to your children? It's like you got a boat with a whole bunch of fucking holes in it, and instead of like taking the boat and fixing it or getting them a new boat, you just tell them, hey, don't worry about it. The holes are, you know, you just put some plugs in there, it'll be fine. And you say, go ahead, children, go off in the, you just don't forget, when I get old, just don't put me in a nursing home. And you know, if you can give me that shot that kills me, you know, give me that shot, and I don't ever be down in a nursing home. That's what you do as a society. It's disgraceful, it's pathetic, and for me, it literally means that all the bad things that you've done to every human being, every bad thing that you have done as a society to human beings is a piece of karma that you is going to come back to you, is a law of attraction that's going to come back to you in the biggest asteroid that you've ever seen rocking this fucking world and rocking you off of it. Or Mother Earth, Shiva coming down and taking Mother Earth, shake them all off, please, and I'll bring down fire to make sure anyone, the ones that survive the you shaking them off. I wiped them away. I mean, I can go on talking like this for ever and ever and ever. But why? Why? It's the same thing over and over again. I'm trying to explain to people. And still they don't understand. Still they give me stupid reasons to why wanting my money should be like, you know. Why isn't that important? We just use it for butter. What, are you fucking crazy? For butter? Fucking people kill for that shit, yo. It's not a bartering tool. It's a fucking mechanism for slavery. It's a reason to murder someone else. If you need their money. You see? You keep on using those excuses. And the deeper it will get, be ingrained. You know, the roots will be like really, really rooted, really, really, really down, real down into your brain. Money is the root of all evil. Is he right? Satan equals evil. That means that money is actually the root of Satan. Yeah, that's what it is. So, I think I'm done now. Gotta get that out. So, happy 420, everybody. And if you ever spent time in jail for the plan that they just made legal in New Jersey, they made it a little while ago, but they actually made it so you can actually buy it in the dispensaries on Thursday. Do yourself a favor. Go somewhere, you see a cop, roll a joint, get out of the car, and smoke it in front of them. I do that all the time now.